Jason, why are you Christian today?
Why am I Christian? Because
you could be Muslim. Why you are not Muslim, but you are Christian?
I'm not a Muslim, and I am a Christian because I know for a fact that the Quran says that Jesus did not die on a cross, and I know it, John the Baptist said when he saw Jesus, "Behold, the Lamb of God that takes away the sin of the world." And I know when Christ died on that cross, he took my sin away. He paid the price for me. He paid the debt for me. And Muhammad denies the cross. The Quran denies the cross. There's even stories where it showed that he hated the cross. I'm a Christian today because I know that Jesus is the Son of God, and I know that he died on that cross and he gave his life for me, and he rose again, and he's the King of Kings and Lord of Lords. And I would die in front of jihadists preaching that gospel because I believe it with all my heart. And it's got evidence, and the Quran's not got evidence. Jesus died. It's a fact. The Quran is totally wrong. There's no evidence for what they're saying.
Oh, well, it's good to have you in our team and in our big family. This might be personal, but I think you would acknowledge with me that we don't born as a Christian. We're born as a sinful human beings, and in our lives, we make a choice to follow Lord Jesus Christ or choose to not follow him. So when did you become a Christian? Why did you become a Christian at the first place?
30 years ago, I became a Christian.
30 years?
Yeah, 30 years. I became a Christian. It's a long story, but I, just short.
Two-minute version.
The two-minute version is some old ladies in the church showed me love in the church, and I read Spurgeon and another preacher called Dr. Martin Lloyd-Jones. I began to be convicted of my sin, and I began to realize that Jesus Christ was the Son of God and died to save me from judgment. And it was through reading Dr. Martin Lloyd-Jones.
Yeah. Okay, and you do have your ministry. You've got your YouTube channel, Jason Burns YouTube.
Yes.
And then you do have your website. So what is your ministry involved? Don't have to answer if you think that's personal.
My ministry is basically, I've been a pastor for quite a few years in the past. And recently, the last 10 years, I've been street preaching. I've been coming down to Hyde Park a bit, trying to help down here.
We always need help, thank you.
But I'm basically really a Bible teacher. And in a few months' time, I'm going to Africa to be the president of a Bible college there. So my ministry really is teaching the Bible, but for the last 10 years, the Lord's been using me just to get on the streets and reach people.
Yeah, and also, as you teach the Bible, as a Christian, we all are responsible to know our Bible.
Yes.
So it is, we do meet sometimes Christian pastors, speakers, they are Christian, yet they never got a chance to study their own scripture, they never got a chance to meditate on their own scripture. So we always encourage people to learn your Bible, love your Bible, and keep your Bible handy, because Word of God needs to be close to us.
Yes.
So you are traveling to Africa. Which part of Africa are you going?
Ghana.
Ghana. Okay, good. And how long are you going to stay there, and what are your responsibilities over there?
I'm going to probably there for about 5 years. I'll be the president of Grace Bible College and Theological Seminary. We have three staff, and we should have some more staff in the next year. And basically, we're there to train young people to do mission and to train pastors. And basically, the reason why is I just believe that there's a need in Africa for men and young people to know the Word of God. And to teach the Word of God, rather than just, there seems to be, I don't know if you've been in Ghana, but if you go in Accra, you have these billboards of these pastors advertising the churches, selling things, making money. I want to help raise a generation that teach the Word of God and feed the flock.
Yeah, so there is false gospel is going around there, you will be preaching, you will be helping people to learn what is real gospel and people to preach the real gospel. Oh, well, it's going to be a big loss for UK for next couple of years, but I'm sure God is going to use your gifts to bless many people over there.
Thank you.
We pray that 5 years goes faster.
Thank you. Thank you very much.